Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage. Junkyard Dog is going to be going against your man, adorable Adrian Adonis.
And here he is, adorable Adrian Adonis. We've got a big surprise for you, Dog. Daniel. A big surprise.
All right. Do you prefer that I call you adorable or Adrian?
Adorable, if you may.
Adorable. How did you ever get the name Adorable?
Well, one morning I woke up and I thought I was Mrs. Adonis.
Listen, I would just as soon not... You let your personal life interfere with your professional career. Let's talk about the Junkyard Dog.
Let's
adorable.
Talk about him. You know what he's spraying there? It is not high fashion cologne. It is flea spray. It is not Hart's Mountain. It is disinfectant. You got to remember, a man that lives in a junkyard, he is very dirty, unclean. And I'm going to tell you something, Mr. Dog. You think you are rough and tough. You have not faced the wrath of Adrian Adonis. Because you got to remember this. I come from the gutter, too. But now I am floating into the picture, and I am going to become champion of all. And remember this. Your bite and your bark does not matter to me.
Very good. Good gracious. Madison Square Garden this coming Monday night, fans. We'll see you there for the...
It's cheap looking. You see the stupid underwear. You know, every arena I go to around the country, whether I'm with adorable Adrian Adonis or I might be with the Funks, the Junkyard Dog by branding me on national TV, now all of a sudden these stupid fans out there, when I go places, they throw me underwear like this. I don't wear underwear like this.
What kind of underwear do you wear?
None of your business.
No, I've seen your...
Of course you have.
Well,
the whole
I do.
Oh.
I love them.
Adrian Adonis. Hey, Hoss Funk, gentlemen. Forget it. Those are Jimmy's.
I think they're rather...
They're not my underwear. They're not mine.
All right, Adrian Adonis.
Gene. Take a look at Adrian Adonis and take a look at old Hoss Funk.
Fine, baby.
Now, what do you see? I'll tell you what.
I wouldn't touch that with a 10-foot pole.
I'll tell you what, we might look different.
What about a 5-foot?
But Jimmy Hart is putting...
Sit on your tongue. None of your business. I'm not going to tell you. And I'm not going to tell you where the anvil is. And I'm not going to tell you where Brett the Hitman Hart is. But I'll tell you who's right here, baby. Jimmy Hart, the mouth of the South. Hoss Funk and adorable Adrian Adonis. And I'll promise you this. We'll be the most predominant force in professional wrestling in 1986. And you can take that to the bank.
Bank?
That's right.
And
take
we'll
it
never
to the
see
bank.
Tobacco Road.
That's right.
All
baby.
Right.
You can tell him,
Hoss, do you care to divulge where Terry Funk is at?
Terry
your
Funk
brother?
Is in very, very serious training.
Right. That's right.
There's another name that we haven't mentioned yet either, Ricky Steamboat.
Kane!
Feudal Sword.
Woo! Look at that! Wow! This is it, McMahon.
You're
not embarrassed. You're not embarrassed when you walk through shopping centers.
Of course I'm not embarrassed when I walk with Adrian.
The jam that was in there for...
All right, well...
This is his first TNT appearance to join us here without his manager, Lou Albano. Mr. Albano wants to, as much as possible, move our next guest in sort of the mainstream, if you would, and felt that now was the time for him to step out on his own. And so Lou is in the back, but he apparently is not going to join our next guest. He's on his own. Would you please welcome George the Animal Steele? Yes. Maybe that too. No, wait just a minute, Adrian, please.
Get him back.
Adrian, you're dripping.
Get him back.
If he wrecks my face,
hey.
If he wrecks my face, Jimmy, spray him.
No,
get
please,
him away from
please.
Me. We'll be back.
The Fuji legend lives on. In a moment, we're told they have brought footage with them. Would you please welcome Mr. Fuji and the Magnificent Morocco. Next next week to join us will be Hillbilly Jim, Bobby the Brain Heenan, along with the Funk Brothers and Corporal Kirsterman. But now, what is this? This is the crowning...
Oh,
this is the final touch.
This is rather special. It could be Adrian of TNT, but it's Adrian of New York.
All right, so maybe you want to turn around and give him the full treatment to Adrian Adonis as we take a look now at the final product. Here is presenting Adrian Adonis in the final form. What sort of response? What do we have here? They do not approve, apparently.
Isn't that gorgeous?
How long does this take in a normal circumstance?
Are you?
Who's filming who right now? You're cutting all everyone's lipstick.
Hello, Liz. My, your lipstick's fab. Who does your makeup?
Well, I do.
Beautiful.
I'm jealous.
Jealousy! Jealousy! Don't be jealous. I'm the champion. I am the champion. You're cutting all everyone's. Just accept things as they are.
Mr. Hogan, I have a feeling, Jimmy, it's just a wonderful combo right here, and it's a swinging trio. Randy, we've tagged up, and we've had a wonderful time, but I just want to close this right now and saying, I love you, and I love
you. Big man down.
Impact on the back of the head.
No, Donnelly, I'm going to knock the Cosby Show right off the top of the list. Notice the pretty flowers. Oh, I love my tulips. Where is my philodendrons? Rudos. Well, it seems to me we have a guest, and his name is Mr. Hillbilly Jim. I don't know if he's from Arkansas, and I don't know if he's from Tennessee, but he's from somewhere. My, what a big one. I want to get something straight between me and you. Your name is actually Hillbilly Jim. On the birth certificate, it says Hillbilly Jim. Is that correct?
No, that's not correct. My name is Jim, and people call me Hillbilly Jim because the part of the country I come from, which is Kentucky, and I'm real proud of it, Mr. Adonis.
Oh, wow. Jimmy Spray. It comes to my attention, Mr. Jim, that the hillbillies are all after me here. And we have a little souvenir from the last hillbilly. Where is Elmer? Now, Mr. Jim, a few cuties, isn't it? Mr. Jim, are you in line for me? Are you after me like Uncle Elmer was? He met with an uncosty little doodah, didn't he?
Let me tell you this, Uncle Elmer's hurt right now. But I'll say this, you'll have to deal with Uncle Elmer.
Adorable Adrian Adonis. And right off the bat, Adrian Adonis, for weeks, you and the Macho Man talked about a washed-up Bruno San Martino, but when the time came to step in the ring, all you two did was run from them.
Well, you know the old saying, live and play and run for another day. That's how you stay alive in the big town of the jungle. Remember this, I am not a pet rat. I am not a hamster. We don't belong in cages. We got the job done before. We made them look like old men. After all, Bruno has been around since Moby Dick was a guppy. Isn't that Randy?
Right, man. Well, this time, Macho Man, there'll be no place to run.
Oh, you're right. And they run, they cannot. They cannot run away in this one, no. Man, I'm a champion, and I know that. But now we're talking steel cage.
And I can drop an elbow, yeah,
from the top of a steel cage and come right.
strike down on Tito Santana, who's on top of Bruno Sammartino, and break both their necks at one time.
At one time!
Saturday night, July the 12th, whatever you do, don't you?
Bubble shop, adorable Adrian!
Hello, how are you, my friend? Today on the flower shop, I might say this week on the flower shop, we have a very special guest, Mr. Bobby the Brain Heenan. How are you?
Right, Adrian. You know, I'd like to say something right here and now. You hold it. No more will anybody see Andre the Giant. He is history. He is gone from professional wrestling. And I did it. I told you.
The road, Heenan. Let me tell you something, Adrian Adonis. How dare you last week try to stir up trouble between me and Mr. Wonderful Man? How dare you try to start trouble? Let me tell you something, boy or girl or whatever. I've been waiting a long time to get my hands on you, man. Now I got more reason than ever. But your time's coming, man. Let me tell you something. Paul Orndorff is like a blood brother to me, man. We've been training day and night together. I've even gone to his house, eaten with his family. Cut over here. I've even broken bread with his family, boy. And his mother said I was like a number one son to her. And all I got to say, Adrian Adonis, I don't ever have to worry about Paul Orndorff because I never have to look over my shoulder with a friend like him. He's the greatest partner I ever had, man. Like I said, like a blood brother. We don't care about the cheers. We don't care about the dolls. We don't care about the work in the ring because we each pull our own load. And all I got to say, Adonis, if you make the mistake of powdering your nose in the wrong place, whether it's Orndorff's business or my business, your lingerie is going to be hanging somewhere in a department store because you're going down. You're going down if you stick your nose in our business.
Who made you? Hold on.
And Adonis waking up. Mario Manson.
Here is the winner, the adorable Adrian Adonis.
Oh, he's great. He's great.
Jimmy Hart, can I make a recommendation to you as one of the great managers here in the World Wrestling Federation?
Sure, go ahead.
Don't let Adrian quit his day job.
Oh, real cute. Real funny. You know, why don't you say something like that when he's out here? But you won't say it because you're not mad enough to say that in front of him.
Very good. I would assume there is yet another fashion to be modeled by the...
That's right. Summer's here. I know everybody's got to get a bathing suit. I know everybody's got to get your beach wear. Well, this is Adrian's new beach wardrobe and bikini. Come on, Adrian. The audience is waiting for you. All right. And here we have a rainbow of vibrating colors. Adrian is wearing a swimsuit cover-up, something that can be comfortably thrown over his swimsuit on the way to the pool. Notice how the stripes point out the accent in his height. The ruffles around his face give a softness which is so becoming to you, Adrian. The colors Adrian has chosen simply reflect his exciting enthusiasm for his zesty, fantastic life. Adrian, where's that pot of gold at your rainbow, baby? At the end of the rainbow, it looks super. Of course, the zipper in the front makes it easy for Adrian to slip in and out of his cover-up as he lounges by the pool or frolics at the beach. His hat... Beautiful, Adrian, it's gorgeous. His hat, with all of its bows, shows the flamboyancy that provides shade to protect his lovely, creamy skin. Super Adrian bikini.
So he should.
Oh, real cute, Lord. You hear that, Adrian? He wants to be funny. Show him those golden legs, Adrian. Look at it. Look at him, Adrian.
Oh, golly.
Are we ready to show him the two-piece aqua bikini?
They look like a couple of stumps on an old fence out in Mandan, North Dakota.
No, look at it. Adrian.
Oh,
Adrian. Adrian, why don't you tease him for a moment? Let's don't show him the bikini just yet. This is a two-piece aqua bikini, girls, and I'm sure.
Adrian. Adrian, if you would, please. Take it off. Take it all off.
Not too much, Adrian. Not too much.
Wait a minute. Adrian,
Adrian,
come back here, sweetheart.
Sweetheart?
I didn't. Don't take that personally. Please don't take that personally. I think one of your...
Mr. Halston, what do you have to say about it?
I think one of your things have fallen out underneath here, Adrian.
Do you mind keeping your hands to yourself, please?
Those are... We call those...
Get those little beads of sweat off your head. I know that you're off.
In the industry, we refer to those as hooters. Lord Alfred, would you buy... You're kidding.
Oh, he just loved that picture. Loved it.
It's meant to be a game. It is a war. Survival of the fittest. Hulk Hogan, you are a brave man. You are a tough man with those 22-inch biceps. Why do you need a bullhorn to whack me in the head? You say about saying your prayers, eat your vitamins. You're supposed to be all-American. Let me tell you something, Daddy. I know what alley you're coming down from, Daddy. And it's not straight and narrow. It's curvy just like mine. It's going to be a war on July 17th, and the belt's on the line. You have everything to lose. I have everything to gain. I don't care about stitches. I don't care about getting whacked over the head. Sure, was tables and chairs. Who did it? It was done for a person to win the belt that night. You cry about a bullhorn. You hit the referee, I'll tell you why. And I'll tell the fans and I'll tell the promoters to save that gold belt around your waist. And everybody out there, all your Hulkamania friends, are all of a sudden crying. And they're going to cry on your shoulder July 17th when I walk out of that ring with that belt around my waist.
The Meadowlands, Thursday, July 17th. Don't you dare.
You're going down.
Slide, pulling it to the south, Jimmy Hart, and perhaps you may consider taking a makeup course or two by the looks of adorable.
You know, 10,000 comedians out of work, and you're out here trying to make a fool out of yourself, but you're doing a very good job of that. Can you believe we're going to let him insult you like that, Adrian?
Insult me? What about him? He gets up in the morning, right, with his head pounding, goes to the medicine chest, pulls it open, takes Preparation H, puts it on his toothbrush, and 2 days later, his gums shrank. Talk about the 4th of July and having a lady with a face of, how could you tell with the pigeons surrounding it? All it is in the White House for a white lady.
Now that, even from you, is uncalled for.
You know, they call me the nerve around town, and they call me Mr. Wrestling. Besides being the adorable one, I have Jimmy Hart, the mouth of the South. But now he's the mouth of the North with me. Combination unbeatable. Two sticks are harder to break than one. Mr. Inside and Mr. Outside. USA Today will be writing about it. Everybody's going to be writing about it. Most of all, everybody's listening.
Perhaps the National Enquirer may be writing about Mr. Inside.
Or even the Globe. Woo-hoo, your favorite. Ladies and gentlemen, everybody knows the adorable one is unbeatable. And the reason is because the marquee says wrestling, and I do it very well. I don't want to take any bows. I don't want to brag. It's just fact, Jack. You can take it to the bank. And remember, you spell wrestling A-D-O-N-I-S.
That'll just about do it for...